I promise you, I will teach you the secret about how you can heal yourself, or you can prevent to get sick. But first, I wanted to give this one, and everybody, I wanted to look to this small piece of pipe. Because we're gonna talk a lot about that one. Like how you know, we live based on the energy. The more energy we have, the more recovery we can have. We see this picture here. This is a human body, and we have seven chakras. What is a chakra? It's an energy point. God created us with the seven energy points, the bigger one, and four auxiliary. One, first chakra is here in the bottom. Second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and the fourth auxiliaries. One, two, three, four. Not the fourth. Based on what medical problem you have. This means in that area, that chakra, get less energy, get closer. You like what is in that pipe? Imagine that pipe is the chakra what you're closing. When it's getting closing, it's look like that pipe. To recover yourself, you have to be able to reopen the chakra, to receive energy. Because the pain or the sickness, that means a block of energy that is creating the pain. And we have to work out to let the flow energy working. I give you an example. Somebody who have thyroid problem. What chakra is going to thyroid? To the throat. It's the fifth chakra. Okay? What says here? Communication. When it's enough to have a job where you are not allowed to talk. You have a lot of ideas, but your boss is jealous. He's afraid you're gonna take his place and says, oh, it's okay, don't say nothing. And you try to say something and it stop here. Okay? You are fighting with your husband or with your wife, based on the case, and you're not allowed to say. This is why sometimes it's better to scream than get sick. Okay? A smart husband should let the wife screaming, then go with her to the hospital. What we are doing in this situation, when already we create the program and we close that chakra, to open and get recovered. What color we have for fifth chakra? I don't have to look over there. Blue, right? You see all these paintings here in the wall? They are a perfect therapy for healing therapy. It's called chromotherapy. If I'm looking that one with more blue, Each color has a frequency. And I receive that frequency until my chakra get open. Believe or not, a couple of thousand years ago, the Egyptians, doctors, this is how they used to treat the people. They have a rooms paint and the color based on what chakra was affected. You have throat problems, not only, you know, everything what is related with the throat, they leave that person in the blue room. You have a heart condition problem. That is a chakra 4. Everything what is in this area is a chakra 4. What color we have for chakra 4? We have green. Right? You wear a close green, like Adriana has, you know. That mean life. When I'm looking to you, based on what colors you like to wear, I know what kind of person you are, because it's a great harmony in your body. Your clothes is showing your personality. Your hair, the way you wear your hair, you show everything. You cannot hide from somebody who knows metaphysics, trust. It's because he's going work from this direction, work from this direction, but somehow he got you. Because it's a psychology, parapsychology, medicine, everything. I told one time to a friend of mine, he used to do like this. And I told him, you have cholesterol problem. And he was shocked, how I know only from doing this? Because he have blood pressure problem. Everybody was watching that pipe. How you like this pipe inside?
A lot of calcium.
Now?
Yeah.
We're gonna talk about this one too. Believe or not, this pipe I have a couple of months ago from one job. And these people, everybody was sick in the house. And maybe I forgot to mention, I'm going to people's house like a construction designer, but my design is a different way. Somebody called me Dr. Cat, doctor of the houses. Yeah, the houses, they need a doctor too, because I start not too long, a long time ago, a project. It's called Your Home can Heal You or Can Kill You. And I have a perfect example. Your home can kill you. Everybody in the house, they have respiratory infection, sinus infection, and the lady in the house, she have genital problems. She has to go with infection over infection, and they don't know why. And of course, you don't have a doctor for this. You go to the doctor because of you. The doctor give you antibiotic, whatever, you are coming home, you got sick again. Why you got sick again? Because you got poison again. And I was asking them, can I see your water pipes? And they was thinking, I will suggest them to, you know, have extra work and change all the plumbing. And the lady reaction says, no. I'm not going to change the plumbing. And says, I didn't say you need to change the plumbing. But whatever problems you have, I think I know from what it's coming. And believe me, they have more respect for the doctors who are trying to kill them with the antibiotics, because it's proved. All the chemicals, medicine, they have side effects. All of them. You cannot mention one who doesn't have side effect. But they don't have respect for somebody who is coming and discover the problem. Because that person is not a doctor. Nobody call me in the street if I know somebody says, "Hello, Mr. Construction Designer." But if I was a doctor, I'm telling you, they'll say, "Hello, Mr. Doctor," right? But with all this respect for the doctors, they got hurt. And I suggest them, let me cut a small piece of pipe, and whatever, I'll fix it back for free. Just I want to prove you something. And I cut this section, what you see here. Okay? And I bring it to her, because she was the boss. He was with the name in the mailbox. And when I show to her, she says, "What is this? This is from your house." "Oh, another problem. We have water filtration under the sink. We don't drink water from the house, you know." She said, "Oh, okay." And I start questioning. "You are taking shower home or to somebody else?" "Of course I'm taking home. What has this one to do with it?" "Because when you are taking shower home, here there are bacteria. All the hot water is coming through these bacteria. And you are so happy you are taking shower and you are breathing. And you are breathing deep inside. And in 2-3 days maximum, because that is the culture time, you start to have respiratory infection, sinus infection, and you don't know why. I don't suggest to everybody to take a bath. Usually I don't take a bath, and I can explain you why. I asked the lady and says, "You are taking a shower or you are taking a bath?" She was so happy. Says, "Okay, I can avoid this one. I don't get sick because of this, because I don't take a shower, I take a bath." Says, "Really?" And this why he was to the doctor, because you have another medical problems. So what has this one to do? Says, "You cannot believe all these bacteria go in the water. You know, each year 2 million people they are dying from water disease." Scary, no? Over 2 million people. We don't pay attention to this. We are thinking if we buy that water from the store, we are saved. Then you should go take a shower to the store. If you want to be safe. Because the water is coming through these kind of pipes. And this house was only 28 years old. I'm telling you, I cannot believe for 28 years old house. And finally they decide to change all the water system. And now they don't need to see the doctors anymore. And I remember even I was one day helping my buddy Victor, and I was so happy when his mom called him and says, "The water tastes different." No, Victor? Because a copper, it's a therapy with copper, if you don't know. You can get healed with a copper therapy. It's a silver therapy, it's a gold therapy, because each stone, each metal has a frequency. And it's a balance, our frequency. When we go low, this one, it's bring you to the level we need. It's a reason in everything. I don't see here too many people know to cook in the copper pots. In Europe, usually, they are looking for copper pots, not stainless steel. People, they used to eat with a silver spoon. Why you think? It's a reason, but in time, like how I told you, all these secrets was hiding from us because the insurance company need to survive, to make money, and to make, you know, millions and millions and millions. And if you don't have sick people, they all fall apart. About the chakras, I think we don't have to go too deep because I'm gonna hold classes about this, and who will be interested is welcome. I'll just put little seeds for who wanted to understand. I answer every day to a lot of emails from all over the world. And I think 80% they are women, because I can cover some of their problems. And I give you an example. One of the cases was a lady, she used to have for maybe 40 years abdominal pain. And she saw tons of doctors. The doctors, of course, put her an antibiotic, go home. Again, she have a problem. Put her an antibiotic, go home. Because they are treating the effect, not what it's causing the problem. As in metaphysics, we are treating what is causing the problem. And for each chakra, it's a code. What energy? Of course, if we stay here, first and second chakra, what is over there? It's procreation, sexuality, right? Mm-hmm. Procreation, who is related with the procreation? Our parents. Who procreate us? Our parents, mother and father. Guess what? If you'll hate your mother or your father, you're gonna have problem with that chakra. Ovarian pain, all this. Because it's an energy. God says you are not allowed to judge your parent, no matter what, how, you know? It's an alcoholic, it's a in jail. We are not allowed. Our parents give us the life. One of the universe rules, respect the parents. Doesn't matter if the parents, they are divorced. Respect the parents. Don't love the mother more than the father, or the father more than the mother. No, keep the balance. That is for your own good. If not, our body have the left side. It's a female, doesn't matter if you are a man, okay? And the right side, it's a man. If you're gonna hate your mother, of course, will be, or if you, like a man, you're gonna hate the woman, of course you'll see the affection on the left side. That is the female part. If you're gonna hate, you are a woman, and you're gonna hate the man because you have a husband, ex-husband, he hate you, you hate him, that energy is coming back. It's a rules. You send that energy, it's like I'm sending to that wall, it's hitting the wall, it's like a ball, and it's coming back and hit me. And what is hitting me? Why you think in this society people doesn't want to accept, but I wanted you to do the research and see why a lot of women, they have ovarian cancer, breast cancer. I'm sorry to say, but it's something what it's sending and receive after. Okay? God create a balance in everything. Not the man, it's a man, and the woman, it's a woman. You have to be slave, me, I am a man, and this. Now, with this feminist society movement, the woman tried to go like this. Before, in 1960s, was a balance, believe or not, was a family value. A family value is a strong society. Now, the society try to don't have a family value anymore because they don't want two people to have one mortgage or to pay one rent. They wanted two people to pay two mortgages or two rent, to give some money to the lawyers. It's a consuming system. You became part of consuming system. And at the same time, because you create that hate between you and your partner, okay? Now you'll be shocked with what I'm gonna tell you. You make sick your kids because there are two energies and the kids, they are in the middle. This energy is hitting the creation. What is your creation? Your kids. And they have brain damage, brain development, and all this. Don't think my son, he got this problem because happened. God put me in all this situation to understand and to accept. And my job is now to prevent the others to don't be in that situation. I don't make a penny from what I'm teaching people. I'm doing this for God. Maybe somebody else told you what I'm telling now. Maybe it's for the first time, but you can do the research. We are okay?
Yes.
Another thing what can get us sick. God create, when he create the world, create, it's called harmony. It's 24 hours cycle. He divide in three. 8 hours work, 8 hours do something for your soul, okay, and 8 hours relax. That is for the body. And this society, guess what? We are working 16 hours, we are reading maybe half hour, and we don't watch TV, this, and maybe we sleep 4 hours. We destroy the balance. When you destroy the balance, you get sick. No matter what. Sooner or later. Because it's that 120 degrees between. Yeah, a cycle has 360 degrees. If we divide in three, it's 120 degrees angle. It's considered the perfect view of the light. We make this angle bigger, the other one is getting smaller. It's common sense and everything. And to get healthy back, we have to create the harmony. Doesn't matter if your boss is telling you you have to stay 12 hours today and work. You said, oh, I have to stay because he's fired me. Yeah, you'll stay today, you'll stay tomorrow. But guess what, when you're gonna be in the hospital, your boss will not gonna visit you to come 3-4 hours every day to visit you because you work 3-4 extra hours. Every day. You know, you have to consider you want to be part of the system or you want to live in the harmony. The system is creating to hook you. Okay? Mortgage, cars, payments, all this. Credit cards. I don't have any credit cards. I have only cash. Why? Because even me, I can be hooked really easy. It's so easy to give a piece of plastic and give and give and give, and when the bill is coming at the end of the month, I have headache. He says, I can't believe. I remember a friend of mine says, I can't believe I was that stupid to spend that much money in 1 month. Because this is how it, you got hope. You just keep, oh, it's so hard to sign over there, doesn't matter. Today is 50 bucks, tomorrow is 30, and in 2-3 transactions like this, 100 is go like this. And after, you have to pay. Some people, they don't understand this. Everything, me, I used to call in one of my books, modern slavery. If you cannot afford to go cash and you need credit cards, this means you don't make enough money. You cannot afford, you know, a lot of things. And if you cannot afford, live, and how much you can afford. Because we don't need for 3 people, for 2 people, a house with 5 bedrooms and 5 beds. Bedrooms, no? We sleep in 1 bed. You ever try to eat with 3 spoons? We are eating with 1 spoon, right? And everything we have to keep in balance. In this society, we lose the balance really easy. And we accuse the government. The government is his fault, is his fault, is his fault. No, it's your fault, you accept it. I'm sorry. You know, if somebody throws some water and you saw the water, but you cannot walk like this, and you go through and you fall, we have to be more careful about this. I know many of you, they are familiar with the quantum physics, right? Maybe you are disappointed today. Maybe not. And the quantum physics says, whatever you wish, it's coming true. Right? I can say yes. It's coming true. You want to be a doctor? You can be a doctor. You want to be a construction guy? You can be a construction guy. But again, we get back to this Bible. I told you we'll talk a lot about this. You see, original was a big diameter, and in time, gets smaller and smaller. And I don't know if I can get this pen through. What happened? If in numerology your number didn't say you are good to be a doctor, you can be a doctor, but not a good one. Okay? I know my number. My number is number 10. Guess what? What is number 10? Teacher. Or reduced to 1, a leader. Always I was a leader. From when I was a kid. I feel that, and I didn't know back then about numerology. You want to be by Hollywood. If you don't have the number to be actor, you'll never be a good one. You'll be an actor, but just 5 minutes in 1 movie. In the future, and maybe you'll remember this day, but I'm telling you now, in the future, even this country will place you in a job based on your number. Not a, don't confuse with social security, based on your astral number. Because you are coming with that number with you. That is everything you are. When I mention a number 1, of course I'm gonna look to have a leader who is number 1 because he was born to be a leader. I'm not gonna look for a number, 6. You know, everybody has his destiny. We can change things in our life. Everybody, we want to be leaders. Maybe me, I want to be a doctor, but I didn't was born to be, I don't see my, to be a surgeon. If you don't see my hands, and my friend is called, I have sausage fingers, big ones, I have to open that body, you know, to feel my hands. I cannot see myself to play piano. It makes sense. Yeah, I would love to play piano, you know, to in front of a lady and not convince her how, you know. No. And this means I can do a lot of exercise I wanted based on quantum physics. I want to play piano. Guess what? After 20 years, maybe I'll play jingle bell, and that's it. You know? It's based on the number. Don't ask somebody about spiritual things if he doesn't have the number. A lot of people, and I saw in a lot of books, they cannot accept this. No, it's not true. God created us the same. Yes, it's true. God created us the same. The only problem is we develop different. It's why you think a secret service, when they hire people, they are looking based on your number. You know that? Yep. They are looking for people with high frequency. Today, if they need you to be a garbage man, you can be a garbage man, you learn fast. If they wanted you to be a pilot, you'll go on the mission like a pilot, and a couple of days they train you, they teach you how to fly. That means high frequency. And they are watching. Says, okay, now don't consider everybody will go on the secret service, but from 1,000, they will have 100. It's, if you don't believe in this, I will give you another example. I used to say, if I will hit you one time with a hammer, maybe it's not enough, I'll try three times. You don't believe in numerology. How you can explain it? Most of the presidents of the United States, they have number 11. Hillary Clinton, Bill Clinton, Obama, Michelle Obama. And guess what? That number, it is predestined to be a president of the state. Doesn't matter if you are in the United States, Romania, Russia, that number. Because that number, normal, it's a God number. God, it's number 11. And these people, they are gods. I know it's hard to believe. Yeah, they are reincarnation. There are many gods. Now you are confused. Okay? Somebody says it's only one God. Yeah, it's a main God. But everybody is God. I am God, you are God, you are God, you are God. God creating us. But God give them the value to be our leader, number 11, okay? If you are manager in one company or boss of the company, right? You are a boss, you have a manager. That manager has the skills to fire you, to hire you, right?
Yeah.
The same like the boss. Why you think God didn't came today here? He's so busy, trust me. And he sent me. Says, Cătălin, you have to go over there. You're not gonna believe. I'll tell you a little story. In one meeting with God, he told me he decided to be a spiritual teacher. And was after an Orthodox monk, you know, asked me to become a monk, and this, I says, come on. I want to enjoy the life. I don't want to become a monk. I don't see myself, you know, in the churches, you know, Pentecostal, Baptist church, whatever, you know, to go over there like a priest. And no. And I told God, I says, no, I don't want to be this. How am I going to survive from this? Because I know it's a voluntary work. How am I going to do my living? I'm a construction designer. This is how I'm doing my living. And God says, you know, this is what I decide. And anyway, the project that we're going to start Tuesday, that this was Friday. Usually on Fridays we have a meetings when we have a time. Says the project what we're gonna start on Tuesday, it's canceled. I wake up Saturday morning, says, man, God cannot do this. God is good, you know, kind. He can cancel my job to hurt me, you know. I live from month to month, you know. How I'm gonna pay my bill? Saturday was gone. I said, oh, it was a dream. Sunday was gone. I was convinced of the dream. It says, cool, nobody canceled my project. Monday was almost gone. 5 minutes before 9 o'clock, and if you don't believe me, I can prove you any time. They call me. Sorry, we need to cancel the project. And I was laughing. And the person was thinking it's my nervous reaction. You know, some people, they're screaming, some they're laughing, you know. But how I can tell them, God told me a couple of days ago, you're going to cancel this project. And I was keep laughing and says, you are okay, Kat, you are okay. I said, no, I'm okay. I'm sorry to say that, and, you know. He says, no, I am okay, don't worry. Whole week, I was involved in all kind of stuff, charity, all this. Next week, I said, you know, I can cheat a little bit, God. Why not? I'll go back to work. I put something else on schedule. Honest. Monday, he says, oh, you want to play? We can play. He's smart, trust me. And he has a lot of passion. He says, okay, I wake up 5 o'clock in the morning, I have to leave my house, you know, 7 o'clock. I got in my car, he let me drive 2 miles. He says, I want to make you feel you go back to work. After 2 miles driving, I receive a phone call. I was looking and said, man, who is calling, you know, 10 minutes before 7 o'clock. The client says, Kat, sorry, something come out, you know, I have to leave the house. Can we reschedule? Oh, I'm okay, don't worry. I turn back home and says, thank you, God. Again, and this is true work, whatever. It's not story I'm making up. But in my mind, I says, tomorrow I'm going back to work. I put something else in schedule. God, again, was in the position. He knows, says, don't worry, you know. Next morning, I wake up. I called the client the day before, look, tomorrow we can start, no problem, I'll be by. I wake up the same 5 o'clock, make my coffee, shower, everything, get ready for work. This time says, man, okay, yesterday I let you go out, drive, today I'll be more nice with you. I step to my front door, and the phone was ringing. And it says, okay, I know what is. And I start talking. Says, God, okay. I took my shoes, you know. And the phone was keep ringing. And I said, okay. Ringing one more time. And the client says, sorry, we need to cancel the project. The man, I have to be so stupid to don't see all these messages. you know? Never happened in 17 years. Like cancel, 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 cancel. When God has a plan with you, your plans doesn't. We try to be, I don't know what, but sometimes maybe God wanted create you for something else. You think many years ago I was thinking I will be here in front of you when my dream was a different one? No. I was thinking I will be big secret service guy, so powerful, with a lot of guns, with doing with the guns like this, you know, left and right. Yeah, because that was the age. I worked in the system before. And no, God put me in each thing little bit, to learn. I remember a couple years ago, somebody from a legal organization, they try hard for 2 years to have me part of the system. And says, no, I don't have time for this. I don't want it. One time I was driving, and like how Carol said, she received message. Sometimes I wanted to pay attention. This is the same a little secret. You try to have a dialogue in your mind with somebody. I'm pretty sure a lot of people, you are driving, you start talking with somebody, somebody who you don't know, somebody who used to say, I'm talking with myself. Actually, we are talking with the voice inside us, but we don't pay attention. This is why all the time listen to the voice inside you. Because if you don't listen to the voice inside you, and especially when it's telling you, but not the one says, oh, go, hit him. That is a different voice. It's coming from the dark side. You have to, you know, have a little common sense. If somebody told you, don't turn right here, and you'll keep turn, guess what? You'll have an accident, the police pull you over or something. It's something who is preventing. We have a lot of protection. And we're gonna talk about the protection too. We have to listen to that voice when we start talking. If you'll ask me why I have that connection back and forth, maybe because my pipe, you know, it's called silver line, it's not like this pipe inside. Maybe it's more clear. Maybe it's more clear. I don't want to try to be full of me. But always, I put the priority to others, not me. If somebody called me 2 o'clock in the night to help them, I was there. And I got home, and my wife, she was jealous. She was thinking I was with the woman. But I never was thinking, because I was thinking, I am so poor, you know, the purity inside, the way I'm thinking to do something good, I didn't know I'm gonna hurt her feelings. I was thinking, you know, she'll gonna understand. My mission was first, I saw all the time a reason. If I got somebody, okay, I know it's a reason why I met that person. This is how it's working. About a protection shield, you know, it's an energy. Somebody can have that thick, somebody can have that thick. How we build that protection? Based on what we're doing and what we're thinking. Like how I told you before the lunch. People, they are thinking. I give you an example. If you are thinking you are working car dealer, and somebody is coming to buy a car, and you hurt that person, because you are working in the commission, and you see that person, it's nice, and you make that price huge, you add 3,000-4,000 more, and you are thinking, oh, Sunday, I'm going to go to church. I made 3,000 from this guy. I'll give 1,000 to the church. God forgive me. For another 2,000, I'll keep for me. And everybody's happy. A lot of people, they are thinking this way. That is the bigger mistake. You cannot do that. Because doing one time, two times, three times, this is how you're going to look inside. That is the quality of your life. Miserable is the right word. And you bring hate from this point, from this point, from this point. And because all the good things you did and all these years, you don't have a protection. Your shield is that thinner, 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 thinner. And the negative energy, because when you hurt somebody and you make him to pay a couple of thousand more, that will bring you hate. Down the road, that person will discover, right? And bring you hate will hit you. And it's creating somewhere like a dark spot. When it's creating a dark spot, that is the first sign you're gonna get sick. And that dark sign is penetrating, go deeper and deeper until physical you got sick. And when you got discovered with cancer, actually that cancer was installed a couple of years ago. When I ask people what you did a couple of years ago, 3, 4 years ago, oh, nothing. No, you hurt somebody based on what chakra is affecting. It's common sense. How long you are doing good things, God give more protection. We build. How we build the immunity system, we build our protection, right? When you go outside and it's cold, you take more clothes, put more clothes on, right? The same if you don't want to get sick, try to put more shields of energy protecting you. Yeah, we're gonna penetrate 1, 2, 3, but you know, when it's getting deeper, deeper, it's different. To build that shield, we have to concentrate every day to do something. I have a reaction. I'm a human being like you. Sometimes, once in a while, I got mad too. But after, believe me, I go to that person, I apologize. And I said, I'm sorry. Doesn't hurt you to say, I'm sorry. I was under stress. I was tired. I make mistakes. Everybody makes mistakes. And give that person a hug. Doesn't cost you nothing. Because when you'll get sick, you prefer to give 1,000 hugs to that person and stay on your knee just to feel good. And you don't want to be in that situation. It's better to prevent than get in the point who don't know what to do. About the seed milk, you'll see actually what's going on. Each seed has a high frequency. This is increasing your immunity system. Because antibiotic mean anti-life. This is what mean. It's like atomic bomb. Right? It kills everything, and after it's rebuilding the immune system. This is improving the immune system, which is the same like you go to war. You have 1,000 soldiers, you bring 10,000 more. And of course, you win the fight. This is how it's working. A lot of people say, oh, it's only seeds? No. It's called germinal therapy. When that seed is in that process to germinate, to give a life, over there it's involved a lot of energy. A lot of energy, I'm telling you. And that energy, actually what you're doing, you take and put in your body. Because we live with energy. We build the immunity system stronger. You see how they used to send more soldiers. This is what we are doing to protect. It's really important not only how we are eating. It's really important how we are thinking. Don't get connected in the past. Don't. Forget it. You cannot change. A past, it's a past. It's gone. Try to concentrate on today. And how God says, be prepared like you're dying tomorrow. You know, actually, it's, he says different, like is the last day today. Why you think? A lot of people says, oh, I will go have fun, go to see this movie, go to this bar, because I wish for 20 years to go in that bar, and I didn't was. Today is the last day, I want to go there. Sorry not. To be the last day, like it's the last day, live with dignity. What nobody else like to do to you, don't do to anybody else. Be the way you like everybody to be around you. Be nice, to be kind. Be nice with everybody around you. That is auto-generating energy. Because we bring, never happened to you to meet somebody, a beautiful person, and even after months or years, you still remember that person? You got connected to that person. Because that person was so nice, so kind, maybe did almost nothing for you. 5 minutes, give you time and talk with you when you was in a lot of pain. But that 5 minutes was really important for you. It was the right time, the right moment. About family. Now I'm touching the sensible part. Exactly like your house can heal you or can kill you, and they are not doctors for the house, your partner can heal you or can kill you. No matter what, how good you feel in bed, if it's a negative energy, you'll get that. And I have a situation where the man got sick because the wife is full of hate. Or the wife got sick because the man is such a negative person or so jealous. Or jealousy is a negative thing. I don't agree with the divorce. I'm a family person. If somebody told me when I got married, I'll get divorced, says that person is crazy. I cannot accept the divorce. I know it's not good for anybody. But sometimes you have to save your life. Sounds strange. Because we make mistakes, and when We got married, we don't follow some rules. We looking only on the sexual attraction. And how good looking is the man and how beauty is the lady. And already our mind, you know, how I would like to be with this woman for the rest of my life, but only, you know, not the projects. We don't think, you know, okay, if I'll be sick, she'll take care of me, or he'll take care of me, or no. And guess what? Everything is nice until you got sick. And when you got sick, you see he's busy or she's busy, says, oh, go where he's hungry, oh, stop by McDonald's and eat something. That is not love. That is only attraction. And we don't know how to live in the couple life. Normal, we have to feed one each other with energy and we keep the balance. The same, maybe sounds strange. I don't want to fall asleep. This is really important for you. For me, no, I'm not married. I learn from mistakes. Maybe sounds strange. It's really important. What signs create a couple? If you put somebody who is born in April with somebody who is born in May, what signs they're April, you know?
Aries.
My mom is Aries. I told you her birthday will be 2 days. And I know how kind of she is. And May is Taurus. If we go to these two, what they have? A head. You know, they like, right? The same will be in the family. Always try to show who is stronger. That you call harmony? No. I wanted to talk a little bit about karma. You see, legally, you can go and lie in front of judge, you can go away with a crime, with whatever you are doing. Depend, you know, if you have a good lawyer. But you cannot go away with your karma. A lot of people, they make mistakes. Believe or not, to think, I was gonna hire 7 priests, pray for me, and because I kill somebody, that will disappear. Scientific was proof, and your karma is recording even your activity from the other lives. The priest has his job. Why you think people, they go to the church and pray together? Because it's the energy. It's your energy, your energy, your energy. When you put a couple of batteries together, you have more power, right? It's called praying group. And honest, it's something else when a group is asking God. It's more powerful than only one person. One person can do it by himself based on his vibration. But to be in that high vibration, and when I'm talking about high vibration, is based on how many hertz. Can be hundreds, hundreds, hundreds hertz frequency, okay? A priest, if he's doing the life, what should to do, of course, he have a high frequency. And the high frequency, you know, it's faster and it's covered the area. And this way you can make, the same is with us. Maybe one person It's like a old model cellular. The other one is update, has high-speed internet. And sometimes I'm laughing. I have high-speed internet. When I met Carol first time, honest, I'm reading the energy. If you send me an email or a text message, you can say a lot of nice things to me. When I'm reading, I feel if it was fake or not. And a friend of mine invited me, and I want to see if it's talking with me, you know. From the first moment, I was hooked. Everything was making sense for me. Because I studied all these years, says, man, how come? And we are asking, how come I didn't hear before? How come we didn't discover before? No, God decide when have to be. Maybe we have people who we love them and we lost them. And we are thinking, oh man, if I discovered this recipe 1 year ago, you know, my father, my sister was alive. When I asked God, I said, how many people will have, you know, all before? God told me, says, don't look for quantity, look for quality. It's the reason you are here. You have to feel blessed. God bring you here. Because I understand exactly what's going on. God doesn't look to have a couple of thousand people here. He wanted the right people. He called you missionary. He have a mission for everybody. Somebody was in India, and asked him how was over there. And somebody else told me, you know, India is a hell and a heaven in the same place. There are people who have a gold knobs to the doors, and there are people who they see their kids dying because they don't have a food to give it to them. Now, which one you think is the dark side? The guys with the gold knobs to the doors, or the guys who doesn't have food to eat? We create the evil with our actions. And I'm sorry to say that. God is in control. But maybe around 80% they love more the evil side. Me, I follow the God rules. But if you look around, everybody try to rip you off, to take advantage about you. The credit cards. And don't call, oh, the credit card company, they hit me. No, people who work for that credit card, people who work for that bank, people who work for that dealers, because they are in the evil part. How long they accept to hurting you, because one day they can be in the other side, okay? And they will see how bad is somebody to hurt you. You think how you feel if a police officer pulled you over and you explain him, you know, I was driving fast because my mom has a cancer and I have an emergency. And he says, I don't care about your mother. I have to give you a ticket. He's a man God. Doesn't matter if he's in a uniform. But if the police officer says, I'm sorry for your mom, just be careful, you know? And he let you go. It's different, right?
Yeah.
Doesn't matter if he's in uniform. He's over there, God sent him. Maybe he stop you because you can do something driving, you know? He just pull your attention a little bit. Everything is based on the frequency. Mm-hmm. How long you have high frequency? You're not gonna do something bad, I'm telling you. If I look back to my life, I live with dignity. This doesn't mean if somebody wanted to hurt you and take your life, you'll stay like this because I have high frequency and I cannot hurt anybody. No, it's that low about dignity. You have to, God create you. You are the castle of soul, right? Your body. And the soul, it's a God. If you let somebody to hurt you, okay, to cut you, to shoot you or something, try to kill you, you have to fight for your life. And of course, sometimes you have to protect yourself. It's about judgment, right? But if you try to hurt somebody, I'm sorry, that doesn't come from God. You serve somebody else. How many people, the girlfriend, okay, dump him. He cannot accept, maybe God protect him. Because I got the situation, I'm not, a couple of days ago, this person finished with his girlfriend, he was low frequency, and I tried to explain him. He says, it's not worth it. God protect you. Try to see the positive thing, because always you was fighting. If you got married, you have a child involved, and all this was worse if you separate after. Make sense, no? Now, everybody, his direction, you learn from this experience, and that's it. And says, no, I cannot accept. And said, and what are you going to do now? I'll go and cut her tires. That is coming from God. And after I talk with him, and I explain him, says, yeah, besides she dump you, she's going to put you in jail. And it's like, were you stupid? What do you like to be stupid? This is how it's working. It says, okay, it's happened. You want to force somebody to love you, to be with you? You have to hit somebody? No, it's a judgment. We create the evil. Now, I don't want to, you know, tell you I wake up and the evil was to my bed. I don't want to tell you when you are to a different level, you know? Everybody can see it?
Yes.
What mean that? 2x plus 3 equal this. This is your life. Your destiny. You can change your life and your destiny based on the value of this X. It's so simple. And I was asking, I bother him a lot, believe me, about this to understand. He says, why he put 2X and didn't put 1, 3, 4X? What mean 2? It's you with your soul. It's your body and your soul. Mean 2. The value, what you're creating. A good things, bad things. Plus 3, it's a God father with, you know, the treason. And equal your life. It's so simple. Maybe for some people it doesn't make any sense, but even for me, to the beginning I was looking and says, I don't know, it's so simple for me to, but if this is based on your question, if you want to change whatever is happening tomorrow, you have to put a seeds today. Makes sense, no? This water I can make to make you sick, or I can make it to help you, to heal you. And you can do the same. It's enough just take it, hold it, put your energy, talk nice, lovely, says nice words, positive things, I love you and all this. And you can get healed with this because it's the frequency. The same, the banner, everything, it's about high, high frequency. What we have here, we don't have toes.
The turtle?
Yes. Yes. You know what mean that? It's a prosperity. And this foundation need this. And I didn't create. No, you receive it.
I received it from
that
the
was a sign,
science teacher.
Like God accept this project. Sometimes, believe me, God doesn't allow it. Even if you want to do a hospital, church, school or something, your destiny is not to do that. Because you are not qualified. God says you are not strong enough to do that. And you can destroy something good because you're not doing right from the beginning. What we have here, we have all the chakras. Right? The colors of the chakra. Look the reading part and what color is. If you want to develop your intelligence to be more smart, you should wear this color. It's for brain development, for information. The project tool with your home can heal you or can kill you. And especially now this family is getting bigger and bigger, and we need healthy people. And we need somebody who can say one day, you know, I'm so happy to be part of this foundation. And Carol will gonna take us in the cafeteria area, and she'll gonna train you how to do this milk. And, you know, it's something what you can help your relatives, you can help a lot of people. Don't expect, you know, everybody to believe in this. But I used to say, if I can save a person, life was worth it for me 22 years to study metaphysics. Just to save one life, it's worth it. The same for the doctors. If he can save a life, is worth it to do the medical, you know, school. And in this one, think about it, you don't need a college, you don't need, you just need to feel a new heart. I want to help the others. I want to do something good. I want to create happiness. Because on the other side, you don't see your account from the bank. Trust me. You'll see the other account. It's counting everything what you're doing, good and bad. And if I keep was sending back, was because I believe in this, And if I'm convinced 200%, this means I can convince the others 100%. Some people, they don't believe in God. Some people, I don't force anybody. It's his choice. It's her choice. How I can prove I saw God? I cannot prove. I cannot prove how looked the electricity, but I can prove the effect. We have the electricity because we have this light. The same, I cannot prove you, okay? But I can prove you on time the effect of God. And one of the effects will be this project. It's a huge project, but I guarantee you will be hundreds of thousands of people around this project. And I am one of them. And when I saw about this project, I was asking myself, why in this life I was a project manager, I was a construction designer, I was an electrician, and not too long time ago, God sent me information about innovation of free energy. Why you think everything? And send me to the Fuji Foundation, no? Because it's a reason. God educate me because he need me in this project. I know I can help in this project saving at least 1 million and something just the way I design. Maybe more. Because I was asking God, I said, how I can help this project because I don't have money. If I will have money, I will help. But I know my contribution will be more than, if I will have money, maybe I'll give, I don't know, 20, 30, 40,000, 100. But this way God says, no, you're gonna give more than that. And it's a reason and everything. And about, you saw these kids, they don't have a light. Look how many lights we have here. They will be so happy to have only one light in their class. What if we don't have to say, thank you, God, you know? Me, I can go to a restaurant to have a good meal. I have a lot of light. I can turn all the lights in my place with no problem. I have a TV in the living, TV in the bedroom, VCR there, VCR there. And these kids, they don't have a classroom. You think it's fair? It's not fair, but we can make to be fair. We have to, sometimes we have to feel guilty for what we have. Because we don't need 7 cars. I see people's red car, blue car, I don't know, maybe they believe in chakras in this way. And, they need all these cars, different colors. 60,000, 80,000 each car, and if you ask them for $1,000 donation, my goodness, they got so mad. And guess what? When they were gonna leave, the cars, you'll see in action. Thank you very much for everything.